The Nakasero based anti-corruption court has granted bail to MPs Michael Mawanda, Busiki County MP Paul Akamba, and the core accused lawyer Julius Chiriataita Nkoko, charged with diverting 3.4 billion shillings meant for Buyaka Growers Cooperative Society. Justice Jane Kajugaku Okwor ruled that all sureties presented to the court were substantial and responsible members of the community. Each of the three was ordered to pay a cash bail of 35 million shillings and deposit their passports with the court's registrar. Additionally, they were barred from traveling outside the country without court permission.
The motions in this case are complete. The matter has been fixed for trial. There is no fear, therefore, that they will be tampering with investigations. There is no evidence that the applicants previously obstructed investigations or that they will tamper with witnesses. They have fixed places of abode within the jurisdiction of this court and substantial sureties to stand for them. They have responsibilities to their families and constituents.
The trio is jointly charged with former Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Trade, Geraldine Salim, Elgon County MP Ignatius Wamakuyu Mudimi, and Principal Cooperative Officer in the Ministry of Trade, Leonard Chivundira. They are accused of stealing 7 billion shillings intended for the Buyaka Growers Cooperative Society's compensation, a case which has garnered widespread attention.
Well, this judge produced a very balanced ruling, taking into consideration the law, the policy, and the expectation of the country. Freedom of the individual vis-a-vis the need to ensure that he attends trial.
We are very happy our friend has been released on bail.
He's going to fulfill, or he's not going to abscond court, and he'll be in position to comply with the terms.
Judge Jane, who granted the bail, emphasized that the decision was made in line with the constitutional rights of the accused, while ensuring that justice is served. The judge also warned that any violation of the bail conditions could result in its revocation. With about 150 days left before EU market begins implementing its tough ban on the import of deforestation-related products, Ugandan farmers, exporters and regulators are worried. According to legislation passed by the EU Parliament in December 2022, all coffee exported to the EU market must originate from land that has not been forested for at least 2 years before the regulations, with enforcement beginning on January 1, 2025. Today, coffee farmers and traders met with Minister of Agriculture, Animal Husbandry and Fisheries Frank Tumwebaze, who assured farmers that most Ugandan coffee farms meet the standards set by EU, therefore no need to panic.
Fortunately, and why I was telling the people that there's no need to panic, we've not cut down any natural forest to plant coffee. People, our farmlands have been here, the forest areas are known. Nobody has cut Mavera to plant coffee. Nobody has cut Chibare Forest to plant coffee. No, so it is people's farms where they have lived for years and years.
Robert Kabushenga, one of the leading coffee farmers, has called upon other farmers to register as one of the requirements for compliance, highlighting its importance in setting coffee prices. He, however, highlights the challenge of lack of political leadership to champion the registration process.
We need to reframe this conversation. In 2019, December, when UCDA proposed a new law about registration of farmers, I was one of the first people to come out in opposition to it. Honorable Minister, I have since changed my mind. Why? I think that with or without EUDR, farmer registration of coffee farmers in the manner in which EUDR wants us to do it is absolutely essential.
Approximately 60% of Uganda's coffee is shipped to European Union member states, including Italy, Germany, Spain, Belgium, Portugal, Switzerland, Sweden, and the Netherlands, making the EU the primary export market for Ugandan coffee. Uganda, through the Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, is racing to put in place measures that will guarantee that its coffee is free of deforestation ahead of the January 1st, 2025 deadline. U.S. Vice President and Democratic presidential nominee Kamala Harris says the stakes in 2024 are even higher and calls for all Georgia voters to do it again and vote for Democrats in November. Vice President Harris pleaded with Georgia voters for a repeat of 2020 when President Biden carried the Peach State and two Democratic senators were elected. Biden won Georgia over then-President Trump by fewer than 12,000 votes in 2020, becoming the first ever Democrat to win the state since 1992. The Trump campaign is eyeing the state as a pickup opportunity, and the former president and Georgia governor Brian Kemp appear to be patching things up as part of an effort to help achieve that goal in November. Harris has spent the past 2 days campaigning on a bus tour in Georgia with her running mate, Minnesota Governor Tim Walz. Recent polling from Immersion College Polling and The Hill found Harris leading Trump by only 1%, pointing the pivotal swing state. Harris spent much of Thursday's rally making the case against Trump, hitting him over Project 2025, the conservative blueprint for GOP presidency that the former president has sought to distance himself from, and over the Supreme Court's recent immunity decision.
And we will move forward. Ours is a fight for the future. And it is a fight for freedom.
The Supreme Court in July carved out broad criminal immunity for former presidents, which handed Trump a major legal victory. As he fights his criminal indictments.